Each node in a hierarchy has its unique location in the hierarchy structure. In a viewpoint, use the Locations tab to view all the locations of a node in a hierarchy along with the ancestry, easily move between locations, display node properties for each location, construct expressions to derive property values, and enforce validations. Let's see how to use locations. To view all the locations of a selected node in a viewpoint, select the node and click on the Locations tab. Notice that the locations are grouped by the immediate parent to identify locations that have a common parent or unique parents. To move between different locations, use the navigation arrow. Each location displays the ancestry in the breadcrumb format up to the top node of the viewpoint. So, you can view many locations at the same time. Expand one or more locations to view them in a tree format to visualize the nodes in the hierarchy structure. This allows you to compare nodes between the selected location and other locations displayed on the Locations tab without navigating back and forth. Click on a node in the hierarchy to quickly jump to the location of the selected node. You can display node properties for each location. In this planning viewpoint, the relationship level properties, data storage, planning visibility, and planning member type are displayed. Relationship level properties may differ based on the location of a node. Properties, when displayed on the Locations tab, can be used to compare differences that may be necessary to select a location and navigate to it. For example, the node OFS Total Revenue is a shared member in one location and a base member in a different location. Note that the same properties can also be displayed as columns to aid visual comparison across rows in a grid or levels in a tree. As before, they can also be viewed from the Properties tab for a selected node. A shared node can hold different property values depending on its location, regardless of whether the property value is inherited or derived. If a shared node in different locations belong to the same hierarchy set, the shared node will have the same descendants that are in the same hierarchy in all locations. The descendants of a shared node will be implicitly shared. Observe that the descendants of the shared node, OFS Total Revenue, are implicitly shared nodes and are hence not visible in planning. We have used the planning visibility property to display if a node is visible in the planning application. Planning visibility is a derived property. This property's expression displays the planning visibility status of the current node based on the data storage value of the parent node. If the parent node is shared, the current node will not be visible in planning. Locations thereby allow you to compare property values across different locations for the same node. Properties that are displayed in locations can be defined, inherited, derived. Now, let's see how to display properties for each location. To display properties in locations and grid, open the Viewpoint Inspector and navigate to the Properties tab. Enable display for the properties under both Locations tab and As column. Here, we selected data storage, planning visibility, and planning member type to be displayed in locations. You can display a maximum of 10 properties for a location. You can use locations in expressions to enforce validation. For example, the custom property hierarchy name is used in the validation duplicate nodes in the same hierarchy to validate that only a single instance of a node is present in the primary and alternate hierarchy. The count method for the locations attribute of the node object is used to identify the number of locations where the hierarchy name property is balance sheet or income statement. If the count is greater than 1, a validation error is generated. This is a request to insert a duplicate node into the same hierarchy. However, when this request is executed, the system throws a validation error. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.